I pray at the lotus feet of Divine Mother, Srila Lalita Ambika, and at the lotus feet of my Divine Gurus to help me, to bless me, so that I am able to speak on this Lalita Sahasranam in a very easy and simple manner, so that everybody can understand it. So, we have already covered in the previous videos all the way till shloka number 57, in which we have covered the various aspects and the meanings of the names from Lalita Sahasranam. We have covered meditations on her form, on the chakras, and her war, the battle with Bhandasur, and all of this we have covered. Now we will start from shloka number 58 and go all the way till 70. Chatushashti upcharadhya chatushashti kalamai mahachatushashti koti yogini ganasevita manu vidya chandra vidya chandra mandala madhyaka charu rupa charu hasa charu chandra kaladhara चराचर जगन्नाथ चक्र राज निकेतना पार्वती पद्म नयना पद्म राग सम प्रभा पंच प्रेतासनासीना पंच ब्रह्मस्वरूपिणी चिन्मयी परमानंदा विज्ञान घन रूपिणी ध्यान ध्यात्री ध्येय रूपा धर्मा धर्म विवर्जिता विश्वरूपा जागिरणी स्वपंती तेजसात्मिका सुप्ता प्रज्ञात्मिका तुरिया सर्वावस्था विवर्जिता सृष्टिकर्त्री ब्रह्मरूपा गोप्त्री गोविंद रूपिणी संहारिणी रुद्र रूपा तिरोधान करीश्वरी सदाशिवानुग्रहदा पंचकृत्तपरायणा भानुमंडल मध्यस्था भैरवी भगमालिनी पद्मासना भगवती पद्मनाभ सहोदरी उन्मेष निमीषोत्पन्न विपन्न भुवनावली सहस्रशीर्ष वदना सहस्राक्षी सहस्रपाद आब्रह्म कीट जननी वर्णाश्रम विधायिनी निज निज आज्ञा रूप निगमा पुण्य पुण्य फल प्रदा श्रुति सीमंत सिंदूरी कृत पादाब्ज धूलिका सकलागम संदोहा शक्ति संपुट मौक्तिका पुरुषार्थ प्रदा पूर्णा भोगिनी भुवनेश्वरी अंबिका नादि निधिना हरि ब्रह्मेन्द्र सेविता नारायणी नाम रूपा नादरूप नारायणी नादरूपा नाम रूपा विवर्जिता रिंकारी रिंगमती हृदय हेयो पादेय वर्जिता. सो दिस इज अप टिल 70 एंड इन द नामावली द सेम थिंग स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम 235. वी विल रीड द नामावली एंड द अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग्स. ओम चतुष्षष्ठी उपचाराढ्याय नमः. Chatushashti is 64. So she is worshipped with 64 articles of worship. Usually there is Panchopchar, Shodopchar. Similarly, there are 64 articles. It's a big ritual of Karma Kanda. When we go deeply into that, we will cover that topic. In Panchopchar, you just offer like a lamp, flower, water, milk, and all those things. That is Panchopchar. And then Shodopchar, you offer ornaments, different ornaments, the dress, fragrances. Similarly, those 16 upcharas or 16 type of worship, it's further divided. Goes into more details and it becomes 64 ingredients. Basically, when you offer 64 ingredients to worship Divine Mother Lalita, that is known as Shashti Upcharadhyaye Namaha. It could be in 64 ingredients, there are different type of vermilions, musk, the scents are of different type, the juices are of different type, the Abhishek water is of different types, so all of this. The ornaments are of different types, so many types, and it is all deeply dealt in Karma Kanda. Om Chatushashti Kalamayi Namaha. So she is Chatushashti Kalamayi. She is expert in 64 arts. So usually in India, 64 arts is considered very high. The arts will include everything. It could be singing, dancing, all of these are kind of arts. So there are 64 types of art, painting, all of these are 64 arts, which are for the material world. But to describe that Mother herself is the embodiment of all art forms. That is why this word has been used. Chatu Shashti Kalamai. All the art forms which are covered in this 64 type of art, everything is nothing but Sri Lalitambika. She is embodiment of art herself. She is not confined by 64 types. She is the 64 types and she is art herself. Oh Mahachatu Shashti Koti Yogini Gan Sevita. She is worshipped by Chatu Shashti Koti. 64 categories, 64 types of yoginis. She is worshipped by 64 types of yoginis. Oh Manu Vidyaye Namaha. She is the subject of Manu Vidya. And Manu is the author or the writer of Sri Vidya. So Sri Vidya has 12 authorities, 12 traditional authorities, and one of the authorities of Sri Vidya is Manu, sage Manu. Om Chandra Vidyaye Namaha. She is the subject of Chandra Vidya, and Sri Vidya as practiced by Chandra is also one of the 12 authorities. Om Chandra Mandala Madhya Gaya Namaha. She is stationed, or she is in the center of the moon. The moon here also represents our Sahasrara. So she is stationed in the center, and when you look at the moon itself, you must always imagine that that is Sri Lalitambika's abode. Om Charu Rupaya Namaha. Charu means very beautiful, very exquisite. Who has exquisite beauty? That is Charu Rupa. Om Charu Hasaya Namaha. Whose smile is very, very charming. Om Charu Chandra Kaladharaya Namaha. Who has a beautiful crescent moon on her forehead? That is Charu Chandra Kaladharaya Namaha. Om Charachar Jagannathaya Namaha. Charachar, whatever living and non-living things, moving, non-moving things, animate, inanimate things you are seeing in the universe, she is the one who is the supreme sovereignty over them. She is the controller. She is the queen of all the animate and inanimate thing in the universe. Om Chakra Raj Niketanaya Namaha. Her abode is the Chakra Raj or the Sri Chakra. Om Parvatiye Namaha. She is Parvati, the daughter of the Himalayas. Om Padmanayanaya Namaha. She has lotus petal like eyes. We discussed about the lotus petal, very oblong, so that she can see all the devotees in every remote corner of the universe. And the lotus has a cooling effect. So when you look at her, your mind will be getting that cooling effect too. Om Padma Raga Sama Prabhaya Namaha. She has a prabha, she has an effulgence or a glowing radiance like the Padma Raga, like the ruby, means a reddish effulgence. Om Pancha Preta Sanasinaya Namaha. She is sitting on the asan of five gods we mentioned earlier, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, Ishan and Rudra. Om Pancha Brahma Swarupini Namaha. She herself is the form of all this Pancha Brahma. Which are the Pancha Brahmas? We mentioned again, Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, Ishan and Sadashiv. So her form itself is composed of these five Brahmas. Om Chinmayi Namaha. Chinmayi is, she is pure consciousness. Her form is that made up of pure consciousness. Om Paramanandaya Namaha. She is the supreme bliss. Om Vijnana Ghana Rupinyai Namaha. Whatever knowledge is there in the universe that has been crystallized, that we see, that we read, we understand, all that knowledge, that special science is Divine Mother Lalita herself. Om Dhyana Dhyatri Dheya Rupaya Namaha. She is Dhyana, means she is the meditation. Dhyatru, she is the person meditating, and Dheya, she is the object to be meditated upon. So when we are praying to Divine Mother Lalita, understand, slowly our consciousness becomes pure, and the devotee himself will start getting the qualities of Lalita. So she is the dhyani now, she is the meditation, she is the person who is meditating, and she is the object of meditation. Om Dharma Dharma Vivarjitaya Namaha. She is beyond all dharma, all righteousness, and adharma, all that thing which is not righteous. So she is beyond all the good and the bad. Om Vishwarupaya Namaha. She is the entire universe. Vishwa. Om Jagarnye Namaha. She is in the waking state. Om Swapantye Namaha. She is the one who is in the dream state. She Om Tejasatmikaye Namaha. She is the soul, the Tejas of every living entity. That which we experience in the dream state. Om Suptaye Namaha. She is the one who is there when we in the state of deep sleep. So while we are awake, that energy that keeps us awake and makes us do things, that is Sri Lalita. While we are sleeping, that energy that makes us sleep and maintains us, that is Lalita. While we are in dream state, that energy that gives us dream and maintains our dream and be with us and she is with us, that is Sri Lalita, and she is the soul. Om Pragyatmikaya Namaha. She is the deeper, she is the pragya, or the is the soul of totality of all the living beings who are in deep sleep. Means we are all in this world, but actually we are in a state of ignorance, we are in a state of illusion. Okay, but even when we are in this state of illusion, we are still aware. That awareness is Lalitambika. Om Turiyaya Namaha. She is Turiya, or the fourth state, means beyond all these stages, where we are totally awake, where we are in the stage of pure consciousness, where we are in the stage of pure understanding, that is Turiya. So we are in the four stages. One is like we are awake, we think we are awake, we are seeing everything, but we are actually not seeing our real self. We are in the state of illusion. So one state is that of awakeness, one state is that of sleep, one state is that of dream. Beyond these three states is a stage where we are completely awake, where we are aware of the material world, our material existence, where we are aware of our spiritual existence, where we are aware of this body, where we are aware of our soul. That stage is the Turiya. It's a very, very high stage. Many times people read a lot of stuff on the internet. They describe Turiya with certain lights and this and that, but actually that is not complete Turiya. Turiya is a very, very high meditational stage. It takes very strong concentration and practice, sincere practice. Everybody can experience Turiya. It's not very difficult also, but sincerely you have to practice for a long time to experience a Turiya. In Turiya, you are awake, your consciousness opens up, your mind opens up, you're a different person altogether. You realize your soul existence, you realize your connectedness with the universe. That is the stage of Turiya. It's a very, very high stage. So that stage of Turiya is also Sri Divine Mother, Sri Lalitambika. Om Sarvavastha Vivarjitaya Namaha. Even though we have described Lalita as a state of waking, as a state of sleep, as a state of dream, and as a state of Turiya, but Divine Mother is beyond all this stage. Om Shrishtikartre Namaha. She is the one who has created this entire universe. Om Brahma Rupaya Namaha. As Brahma, she is the one who is creating. So Brahma itself is her form, and as Brahma, she is the one. She is the energy of Brahma. Without energy, without power, without Shakti, Brahma is also helpless. So Brahma needs energy to create this universe. So that energy is Sri Lalita. Om Goptrayi Namaha. Whatever she does, Goptra means the one who takes care of you, who maintains you, who protects you. So like in Krishna's name, they say Gopal, he is the one who is taking care of the cows. Similarly, she is Goptre. Goptre means the one who protects you. So she is in charge of protection. So she is the one who creates the universe, and she is the one who is protecting everybody. Om Govinda Rupinyai Namaha. She is the form of Govinda. Govinda means Krishna, one name. But we'll go a little bit in this. Go has four meanings. Go is cows. Go is Mother Earth. Go is our senses, and go is our mind. So understand, the first word was Goptre. Goptre means the one who is protecting, the go. What is the go? The one who protects the cows, go. The one who protects the earth, Goptre. The one who protects our senses, Goptri. One who protects our mind, Goptri. So that is the meaning of Goptri. Similarly, Govinda. Govinda means the one who gives joy, the one who gives pleasure. To what? To go. So the one who gives pleasure to cows, the one who gives pleasure to our mind, the one who gives pleasure to our senses, the one who gives pleasure to the entire earth or the universe, that is called as Govinda Rupinye Namaha. So she is the one who has taken the form of Govind, who has taken the form to give pleasure to everything in the universe. Om Sangharinye Namaha. She is the one who results, who causes the destruction of everything, annihilates everything. Om Rudra Rupaya Namaha. When Rudra, Lord Shiva, takes up his role of destruction, she is the energy, she gives energy to Rudra to create that destruction. Without energy, Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, they are helpless. They all need energy to execute their functions. So Sri Lalita Ambika is the energy behind that destruction, which she gives to Rudra to perform his duty well. Om Tirodhana Karye Namaha. After the destruction, everything goes back to its original state in its primeval conditions. So that purpose is achieved, that goal is achieved by the energy of Sri Lalita Ambika. So she is Tirodhan Kariye Namaha. After destruction, everything goes back to its original state, and that is done by Sri Lalita Ambika. Om Ishwariye Namaha. She is Ishwari. She is the controller of everything. She accomplishes everything. Om Sadashivaya Namaha. She is the consort of Lord Sadashiva. Om Anugrahadaya Namaha. She gives blessings. She is so graceful. She blesses all her devotees, and then she starts the universe again and helps it, every soul to evolve again and go back on their journey. Om Panchakritya Parayanaya Namaha. She is the one who is the reason behind all these five activities, which was creation of the universe. We read it. So first she creates, she is the one who is helping to create, she protects, she gives happiness, then she is the one who helps Shiva in destruction, and she is the one who takes all the things to his primeval condition. And then when the Srishti, when the universe starts evolving again, she is the one who starts the process once again. So all these activities is being done by her, and that is why it is said Om Panchakrit Parayanaya Namaha. All these five activities is being done by her. Om Bhanu Mandala Madhyasthaya Namaha. She is the one, we have to meditate upon her in Bhanu Mandal, in the orbit of the sun. Om Bhairavye Namaha. She is Bhairavi. Bhairavi is the energy of Bhairav. Bhairav is the one, actually Bhairav is a very fierce energy which is required to keep the world in motion. So that energy of Bhairav is Bhairavi, and that is Sri Lalita Ambika. Om Bhaga Malinye Namaha. Bhaga are the opulences. Bhagavan, the word comes from somebody who has bhaga, means there are six kind of opulences, and the six kind of opulences are all power, all fame, all beauty, all knowledge, all wealth, and at the same time all enunciation. Anybody who has this six opulences, this is called as bhaga. So she is Bhaga Malini. She is the possessor of all these four. In the world we can see somebody is very beautiful, but they may not be very wealthy. Somebody may be very wealthy, but they may not be very powerful. Somebody may be beautiful, wealthy, yet not powerful. Somebody may be beautiful, wealthy, powerful, but not knowledgeable. Somebody may be beautiful, wealthy, powerful, knowledgeable, yet they are not renunciated. So like that. So there are different six qualities. With Divine Mother, she has all these six qualities. She has the knowledge, she has beauty, she has wealth, she has power, she has strength, and at the same time she is detached from all these things. That means she is renunciated. So she is Bhaga Malini Namaha. Om Padmasanaya Namaha. So she is always seated in the lotus form, in the cosmic lotus. So again we have spoken about Padmasan in the lotus mind of the devotee. Om Bhagavate Namaha. She is Bhagavati. She is the supreme goddess who possesses all the six kind of opulences we spoke about. All power, all righteousness, all beauty, all knowledge, wealth, fame. Om Padmanabha Sahodaryai Namaha. She is the sister of Padmanabha or Mahavishnu. Om Unmesha Nimishotpanna Vipanna Bhuvanavalyai Namaha. This is very beautiful. It says, we salute to that mother who, when she opens her eyes, the creation of this world begins, and when she closes her eyes, the closing or the destruction of the world begins. So she is the cause. When she opens her eyes, the whole universe gets into creation or motion. When she closes her eyes, everything is annihilated back to its original state. Om Sahasrashish Vadanaye Namaha. She has thousands of heads and thousands of faces. Even though it says Sahasra, it means millions and billions. Every eye that you see in this universe is nothing but Divine Mother. Every soul that you see in this universe is Divine Mother. Every face that you see in this universe is Divine Mother. Shri Lalitambika. That is why Sahasra Shirsha Vadanaye Namaha. Everything that you see, every face, every eyes is Shri Lalitambika. Om Sahasrakshaya Namaha. Thousands and millions of eyes is Shri Lalitambika. Om Sahasrapade Namaha. Thousands and millions of legs that you see in the universe is all Shri Lalitambika. Abrahma Keeta Janinye Namaha. She is the one in Supreme Brahma. She has multiplied, she has divided, she has become Brahma, and she is the one who is in the lowest worm, lowest insect. Om Varnashram Vidhayini Namaha. She is the one who established the Varnashram system of Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra based on the quality of the work and the kind of work they do. Om Nijagya Rupa Nigmaye Namaha. She is the all the Nigam, all the Vedas have been spoken on her command. So Om Nijagya Rupa Nigmaye Namaha. Om Punya Punya Phala Pradaya Namaha. She gives the resultant, the results of all the good and the evil actions. So this is very nice. She is the one who bestows the result of your good actions. She is the one who bestows the result of your bad actions. So if you have done anything bad in life and if you are suffering because of it, whom should you go and approach? You should approach Shri Lalitambika. If you approach her, she is very merciful, she is very kind. She will dispel all the negatives from your life and she will make you as beautiful as her. And as happy as her. As her, as blissful as her. Om Shruti Simanta Sinduri Krita Padabj Dhulikaya Namaha. She, Shruti here, Shruti are the Devatas or the Vedas. So Vedas were are spoken and heard basically, and they were propagated by Shruti and Smritis. Shruti is listening and Smriti is by memory. So Shruti Devatas. So all the Shruti Devatas always worship Shri Lalitambika, and when they all the Shruti Devatas, when they put their head at the feet of Lalitambika, they color the feet of Lalitambika with the vermilion mark on their forehead with the kumkum. So they are worshipping Shri Lalitambika's feet with kumkum. All the Shrutis of the Vedas. Om Sakalagam Sandoha Shukti Samputa Mauktikaya Namaha. She is the one in all the agamas. Agamas are, again, there are Nigam and Agam. These are the ritualistic scriptures of the Vedas, part of the Vedas. And she is like the priceless pearl which is hidden in all the agamas. Om Purushartha Pradaye Namaha. She is the one who provides all the Purushartha. There are four types of Purushartha: Dharma, Kam, Artha, Moksha. So when we pray to her, she is the one who blesses us with all dharma, means all righteousness. With she blesses us, she fulfills all our kama, she fulfills all our desires. Dharma, kama, artha. Artha means money, artha means also the goal. She fulfills all our goals. fulfill gives us all material security, all financial security, dharma, kama, artha, and in the end she provides us salvation or liberation, moksha. Om Purnaya Namaha. She is complete by herself. Om Bhoginye Namaha. She is ever blissful. Om Bhuvaneshwari Namaha. She is Bhuvaneshwari. She is the controller of the entire Bhuvan of the three universes. So she is the sovereign of the universe. Om Ambikaya Namaha. She is Ambika. She is the mother of the universe. And she, as mother of the universe, she is the embodiment of all our Ichha Shakti, our willpower, Kriya Shakti, our actions, and our Jnana Shakti, all our knowledge. Om Anadi Nidhanaya Namaha. She, Anadi means she is always there from the beginning. Nidhanaya Namaha. And there is no end to her. She has always been existed and she will always exist. Om Hari Brahmendra Sevitaya Namaha. Lord Hari, Lord Brahma, Lord Indra, all of them are serving her feet. Om Narayanaya Namaha. She is Narayani or the consort of Narayan. Om Nada Rupaya Namaha. She is the cosmic sound, the bugle, which sets into action the process of creation. So she is the cosmic sound or the Nad. Om Nama Rupa Vivarjitaya Namaha. So even though there are thousands of names by which we are trying to describe Sri Lalita Ambika, but yet she is beyond all these names. We cannot just confine her to these thousand names. That is why it says Nama Rupa Vivarjitaya Namaha. Beyond name, beyond form. We are trying to confine her to this thousand names, but she is beyond form, beyond all names. She is pure Parabrahma. Om Ringkariye Namaha. She is the syllable ring. Ring is the syllable, is a mantra for Mother Bhuvaneshwari. So we already spoke that she is Bhuvaneshwari. Lalita Ambika is Bhuvaneshwari. She is the mother of all the universe. And ring is the pranav mantra. In Shakta Tantras, Rim is the pranav. When we worship a female deity, Shakti, Rim is our mantra. So this is what it is. So she is Ring Kariya Namaha. So that Ring mantra is nothing but Sri Lalita Ambika. Ring is the one which represents that energy Bhuvaneshwari who creates, sustains and dissolves the universe. Om Ring Matye Namaha. Ri Matye Namaha. She is having all modesty. She is very, very modest. Om Hridayaya Namaha. She lives in the heart of the devotee and Hridayaya Namaha and gives the highest satisfaction. So all these things we have been speaking, so many names, trying to describe her, trying to understand her. Whichever name suits the devotee, whichever name you like, you can go on repeating. Every name is a mantra by itself. For like when you say Om Hridayaya Namaha, it is such a simple mantra. Just it should take your attention right to your heart and you should feel, oh, mother is here, sitting here in my heart. Om Hridayaya Namaha. Om Heyo Padeya Varjitaya Namaha. She has nothing to seek. She is not seeking, she is not asking for anything, and she has nothing to reject. She does not hate anything. Everything is hers. Om Raja Raja Chitaye Namaha. She is described as the King of Kings and she is worshipped by the King of Kings. She is worshipped by Lord Kubera. Om Ragniye Namaha. She is the Queen. She is the Empress of the entire universe. She is the Supreme Queen. Om Ramyaya Namaha. She is very beautiful and she is very lovely. I think we'll end it up here. I was supposed to end it up at 3:01, but I went. It is such a beautiful narration that I didn't want to stop, and I went all the way up to 3:07. But we will end it up here for now, and then in the next video we will cover the rest of the things. I hope you all like it. Please chant it with your heart, with full devotion. Whatever words you like, whatever names you like, make it the mantra of your life. Experience it, and whatever experiences you get, anything, please share with us. Please do comment, or any questions, please write to us and we'll try our best to answer it. Thank you. Jai Gurudev.